Yeah, it should be a good one today. Blyth been in good form, obviously, in the clubs as well. Yet to really get going in the league as well. So it'll be interesting to see. They've got pretty much the same side as the Altrincham game, so they should, in theory, dominate Halesowen today. But certainly concentrating on the league now. They need to, obviously, in the relegation zone, they need to start getting their way back up the table.
It's on my way. Header there by Ford, only finding Danny Maguire. Getting away from Hull and then getting away from Ford again. Brilliant footwork from him. He's found Mullen in the centre. Mullen over to Robbie Dale on the far left hand side, just getting into the penalty area now, getting away from Kettle. Pulls back, whips it in on the right foot. It nearly ended up. Whipped in and the header. It's a free header. Headed into the back of the Spartans' net, but the referee had already blown his whistle for a foul in the area on Peter Jeffries, and the Spartans will get the free kick. Griffiths will take a corner here for Halesowen. Swing it into the area, and it's headed on by Mr. Christie, just wide of Peter Jeffries' far post, but it was certainly a chance there for Halesowen. It's difficult to get this one up and over the wall, but it's not the tallest of obstacles for him to aim at here, the Halesowen ball.
You have to question that, because the big centre halves are just stood in the penalty area.
Dale sends it in, and it's gone wide of Matthew Sargent's goal. He tried to go for the gap over on the far side of the wall. Hazley wriggling away from a couple of challenges, but Mullen coming back wins the ball for Spartans. Sent out wide by Hutchinson, the poor touch from Green sends it straight to the path of Danny Maguire. Maguire's in the penalty area, getting away from Hull, sending it past, turning it out of keeping is a good save.
It's interesting to see the Spartans went a little bit more direct. Halesowen in the box.
Christie, good turn away from Hutchinson. He gets the shot away. Hits the outside of the post. And Spartans get away with that one.
Just held his shoulders.
That's the ball is sent forward by Matthew Sargent. Mr. Scott Taylor, referee, blows for half-time. And Wade flicking it on nicely, though. And it's a good pass there by Mullen to Maguire. But Kettle came across, picking the ball off him. On the halfway line here with Griffiths. Griffiths, great ball over the top, and Hazley taking it in behind Hutchinson. He got the shot away, and it rolls past the goal of Peter Jeffries, and four by Hutchinson. For Maguire, the yellow card. And it's clipped over the top there by Mullen, and it's headed on by Butler. And Robbie Dale, the back post, has turned it in completely unmarked. And Blyth Spartans have the lead. And it was sloppy defending. Ball whipped in by Mullen, headed on by Nathan Bottle. And Robbie Dale, the back post, can't leave a man of his ability and mark like that. He's just turned it past the goalkeeper with consummate ease.
It was very, very poor defending there. Just all of them seemed to turn off. It was a bit of an innocuous loop and then over to the game.
And it's whipped in and headed out. Robbie Dale into that one, sent back in, and it's cleared away by Wade just before it could get to Jeffries. A shot from Bregoli wasn't great, and Spartans get away with it here. Hopefully Turnbull turning away from Bregoli, Bell heading it away, and it's Mullen, but he's beaten to it by Turner, and the ball forward is from Thompson Brown. Thompson Brown over the left hand side, and Bruddle slips, and Hazley's in here. He's lifted it sumptuously over the top of Peter Jeffries, and that is a stunning goal, and it's worthy of equalising the game there.
What a fantastic finish that was from Hazley. We talked about his problems before now, and it was just a long ball forward, and Jeffries isn't coming no go, and he's stuck in a bit of no man's land, and he's just tucked it nicely straight over him into the goal. Maxson coming back trying to fend it off from under the bar, but what a fantastic goal.
I think Hazley and Bubble were charging right there. Bubble seemed to stumble, fell to the floor, and that gave Hazley the freedom to judge the situation properly. He saw Jeffries off his line, lifted it over the top of him, and you have to say that that is worthy of equalising the game. There's absolutely no one there running onto it. Jordan Watson can't get rid of it, and there goes the full-time whistle. And